tone production on the harp, I need to know a couple things. First of all, this big old guy is the soundboard, and this up here is the S of the harp. So your strings are attached up here at the S and down here in the soundboard. So for a good kind of tone, you're gonna wanna be close to the middle of the string. Playing too close to the soundboard will stop it from resonating, and you get this pingy sound, which is called près de la table, which is close to the board in French. And it's most of the time something you wanna avoid. Sometimes there's music written for it. But generally for a good tone, you wanna be right about here. And articulate well, which means bringing your fingertips into your palm like this. Like that, so it really resonates. Nice full sound.
All right, so this is how you make a great sound on a double bass. As you can see, this is quite a large instrument. And it has depth. So it's really a giant resonating chamber. You have a top here that's backed by what we call ribs and a baseboard and a sound post that support all of that. And we have a large, most of the time, metal string pulled across what we call the nut and the bridge. And where you want to place your hand is very important, because what we're looking for is what we call the node of the string. And the node of the string, whenever you think of sound waves, and sound waves go like this, well, this being the node. We don't want to be right on that node, which is probably going to be right about here. We want to live somewhere in this neighborhood that's right past it. And you want to pull strongly, but firmly. And not too hard, because you don't want to hurt yourself. A good start is doing that on open strings like this. You think that sounds good, Polar Bear? Polar Bear don't care.
Okay, so to get a good tone on the marimba, as you can tell, this is a very, very big instrument, even bigger than a bass. What you want to avoid, just like on the bass also, are the nodal points of each one of the keys. It's wood, and you have string running through the holes, like drilled into this wood, so like the weight dampens the notes with, you know, resonant sound, but if you play over the nodes, there's no resonance at all because the string is like pushing up against that. So what you want to do is go like put your mallet right in the middle of the bar and then travel about an inch downward, and that's where you'll get the best tone. Okay.
Oh, yeah.